My caption of the presentation is a panacea for all predictive ills and pitfalls. Rashi Chakra can only be the solution. Because Rashi is so important, though it is a conglomeration of many facts and figures, but it contains everything. Next. Why it is so? Because of the fact, all astrologers face problems of time of birth. Unless you correct the time of birth, the whole thing will collapse. In detail, your reading will not be correct, and the final divisions of the main chart will not be correct. Maybe at the most, the Shadvarga, the Shavarga may be correct thereafter. It may not be correct, you know. Therefore, there is one big problem. Apart from that, what is the correct Ayanamsha? We have got a list of Ayanamshas, and people are following a different Ayanamsha. There is another, this is with regard to people who are practicing astrology. We are scholars, we discuss many things, we have got time to rectify the time of birth and so on. But practically speaking, when a person comes immediately, if you want to ask, we have to depend on the time of birth only. That may not be sufficient, you know. Okay. Because the fact, the common astrologer who has to immediately read the horoscope of a person who comes to him may not have time to rectify the time of birth. And that is a big problem. And we scholars, we take time and we have got many methods to rectify the chart. But not so in the case of a common astrologer who has to cater immediately to the client. That is one problem. And for everyone, the Ayanamsha is a big hurdle, you know. Therefore, unless you have a correct Ayanamsha, whatever you do, because the Dasha Bhaktis will change, the position of planets will change in the Rashi chart, in the divisional charts will have changed. Therefore, this is a big problem for any common astrologer. Next. Therefore, you can see Lahiri, Pushya Paksha, Revati Paksha, Pagan, so on, so many Ayanamshas are there. Therefore, it is better on our part to see horoscope and verify the Dasha Bhakti, verify the divisional chart, and for our own satisfaction, correct Ayanamsha to be selected. Then only you do justice for the sign. But apart from that, have to stress that Rashi is a most important chart from which you can understand. That's why when I discussed with Dr. Raman, he also told me there is a discrepancy of 50 minutes in Lahiri Ayanamsha, for which Jain Basin also subscribes to it. That means when the main Ayanamsha, which is followed all over India, has got 50 minutes difference, means you can just imagine the whole position of planets will shift to backwards or forwards 50 minutes. The whole divisional chart will change. Sometimes nakshatras will change. Therefore, this is a thing where one has to do a lot of research. And Dr. Raman himself expressed all these things to me. Okay, next. Therefore, in my view, it is better we stick to the Rashi chart and see what we can understand from the Rashi chart. Therefore, as I told you again, I have repeated here, the correction is needed for final divisional chart, Dashavarga and Shadvarga at the most. For a general reading, AC, it is you can get, but for unless the time of birth is correct, the final division like Chaturvimshamsha, and other Shastiyamsha and other detailed charts will not be correct. Next. Therefore, I thought to exhaust what is available in the Rashi chart. For your information, even the Nadis also take only Rashi Chakra and speak many things on the basis of the Rashi chart. That means you have got so much of techniques and inbuilt informations to understand the horoscope, and we can interpret the horoscope. Therefore, my top focus is only Rashi Chakra and interpreting the horoscope. Though Rashi Chakra has got so much in it, but it is not possible for me to give you everything in a short period of 45 minutes. But I try my best to impress on you by giving some of the important salient points which will be very helpful to you to understand and interpret the whole horoscope on the basis of the Rashi chart. Therefore, I have to stress again, exhaust all available information that you get from Rashi chart. What we do generally is Grahasputa, Bhavasputa, Bhava Chakra and so on. When we say Grahasputa, in the South India, what you do know, Nakshatras, Grahas, Tatkalika, Grahasampatti. We put all planets in Nakshatra Padas. Therefore, we have got 108 Nakshatra Padas in 12 Rashis. Therefore, this Grahasputa helps you in many ways to understand, you know. From Mesha, first Navamsha, first Pada, the Grahas Nakshatra Pada should be counted. That gives you some important event. Therefore, all the planetary position from Mesha, the two from Ashwini 1, which is the first Pada of Mesha, as I told you, 108 Padas are there. A particular planet sits in a particular Navamsha or Pada. When you count it, it may be 40 or 45 or 50 or even 8 or so and so. Therefore, in the example chart I have given, there are events taking place at the 8th year, 10th year. Therefore, even with regard to marriage, so many things we can understand by counting the nakshatra padas from Mesha to the respective planet. And at the same time, from planet to planet, you can count the padas. That also gives you a very important influence of life depending upon the planets involved. Therefore, Grahasputa not only gives you the padas, and the nakshatra lords are so important, you know. For the lagna in which you are born, that graha which is controlling, the nakshatra graha which is controlling the planet, whether it is a shatru nakshatra, mitra nakshatra, and friendly nakshatra, all these nakshatras are based on the Grahasputa only. Therefore, for example, let us say a person is born in Sima Lagna with Mercury exalted in the second house. Generally, we straight away come to the conclusion, oh, second lord is exalted. Therefore, the monetary aspect and the Kutumba aspect is so good. But when you go deeper into the horoscopic observations, we can understand it may either occupy the Mars nakshatra or the Sun's nakshatra or the Moon's nakshatra. Let us analyze the three influences. For example, if a person is born with Buddha exalted in Hasta nakshatra, which is the Lord is Moon, Moon is the 12th Lord for Sima Lagna, that is not so favorable. Then if it occupies Chitra nakshatra, it is occupied by a Shatru nakshatra, that is all not so good. The only nakshatra which can give you good result is the Sima, that is Uttara nakshatra of Kanya Rashi. Therefore, you can just imagine how the nakshatra padas and nakshatras are so influencing everything we get from the Grahasputa. We don't take into consideration the influences of Grahasputa. Grahasputa is so important. And even in the screening of the horoscope, Grahasputa are important, because we place planets in degrees minutes. Each minute of the zodiac can be screened, whether it is in a good nakshatra, Murtibhaga or Pushkar Navamsha or so and so. Therefore, this Grahasputa gives you so much of information for your information. Then comes the Bhavasputa. See, we have Bhavasputa of two types. One is equal house division and another is unequal house division. What is unequal house division? Generally, what we follow from Sripati Paddhati. Sripati Paddhati gives you, according to the latitude, the nakshatra graha, that Lagna Pramana. Therefore, Lagna Pramanas will vary from latitude to latitude. It may be 32 degrees, it may be 28 degrees, and so on. There is not so uniform as 30 degrees of a bhava. Therefore, this unequal division sometimes fails in the higher latitudes, because the midpoints of bhavas fall in such a way that in a rashi you may have two bhavamadhyas or three bhavamadhyas. Therefore, this bhavamadhyas, when you have particularly two or three in a rashi, then it is very difficult for you to decide and demarcate the bhava. Therefore, the higher latitude, it miserably fails. No harm in our practice for us, Sripati can be used. But for practical purpose, this equal house division is very important. That too, after finding the lagna spot, the same lagna midpoint falls in all the bhavas. It becomes the bhava madhya. Now, bhavasputa gives you bhava madhyas of all the bhavas. In what way bhava madhyas will help? It is called midpoint of the bhava. Therefore, our Vedic system starts lagna as a midpoint, not the beginning point. People mistake, it is a cusp. It is, the word cusp is wrong. But it only applies to the Western astrology, where the lagna or the ascendant starts with a degree. That is the beginning part of the lagna. Whereas in our Vedic system, we take madhya bhaga or midpoint or bhava madhya as the lagna or any bhava madhyas. In what way this bhava madhyas are useful? Bhava madhyas are useful because the midpoint has got a degree, and the degree has got a nakshatra, and the nakshatra is the Lord. Therefore, if lagna falls in hasta nakshatra, the midpoint falls in kanya rashi, the sthula rod becomes the Buddha, and the sukshma rod is chandra. You are forgetting the influence of chandra, which is the midpoint of the kanya lagna. Therefore, for the lagna point, two lords are influencing the lagna bhava. Therefore, sukshma lord is chandra, sthula lord is Buddha. We forget the sukshma lord and only take the sthula lord and go on interpreting the horoscope. For your information, Krishnamurti was the only person highlighted the midpoints, and of course he has subdivided the midpoints into the subs and sub-subs. Therefore, he takes into consideration while considering different bhavas. The bhava madhyas are so important for him, and he gives you rashi lord, nakshatra lord, sub lord, sub sub lord. All these are taken into consideration while assessing a bhava. Therefore, you see bhavas chakra, bhavas puta is so important. What is a bhava? Is rashi a bhava? No. Bhava has got a demarcation. It has got a beginning point, it has got an ending point, it has got a midpoint. If a planet has to work, it should be before, after 5 degrees, if it is there in the bhava, it can only give you good and specific results. If it is in 0 degree or 1 degree, 2 degrees, it becomes weak. It will not be in a position to give you good result or the correct result according to the karakatva or adhipatya. Then when the planet is very near to the midpoint, it works wonderfully. That's why bhava madhyas are so important. Apart from the use of the grahas near the bhava madhya, we have to think this bhava sukshma is so important in transit also. Many planets are passing through the rashis. When we see of the gochara, we take generally from Chandrama, different rashi transits we take. But actually what you have to do is, major planets like Jupiter and Saturn, when they are passing through the midpoints of the different bhavas, some specific, important, significant influences are felt. Therefore, bhavamadhyas are so important. And when Saturn passes through a bhavamadhya, as you know, Saturn is a planet of negativity, melancholia, and delay in day-to-day aspect. Therefore, when he passes through a particular bhava, madhya, it delays certain things. Some uneasiness is felt. Therefore, in other words, Jupiter, a most beneficial planet, passing through particularly in the midpoint, it can help you. Therefore, the bhava madhyas are so important, not only from the point of view of assessing the planetary influence depending upon the bhava, but also in the transit also, the major planetary transit over the midpoints of the different bhava are also useful. Therefore, you see how bhavasputa is useful. We don't take into consideration filling 9 planets in 12 houses. We think it is a horoscope. Simply degrees you take, we don't make use of the bhava chakra, bhavasputa also. Bhavasputa means where it is in the bhava. That is in the beginning or in the end or in the middle. If it is in the end, before 5 degrees, it should be to give good result. In the same way, after 5 degrees from the beginning part, it can give. Therefore, you have to make it clear and make use of the bhavasputa and use the planetary position where exactly they are very important. Then comes after making all these things, grahasputas, bhavasputas, we get bhavachakra. What is bhavachakra? 2 rashis may contribute to one bhava. The bhava starting may be from the previous bhava. It may end in the same bhava. Do you mean to say when a lagna is there, that from 0 to 1 degree is the bhava? No. Bhava chakra means it has got a starting point. It not necessarily be 0 degree of a rashi. It may change, it may start. See, it may start from the previous bhava at a particular degree and end in the same degree. Any planet in the previous rashi, before the starting point, it comes to the particular, this bhava. If it is lagna, though the planet is in the rashi in the 12th house, it comes back to the lagna bhava. Therefore, you think sometimes what happens? The ending of the bhava may be in the next house. Therefore, the planets found in the next house may enter the lagna, or the planet which is in the lagna may go to the 12th house. Therefore, the bhava chakra is so important from the consideration of all bhava readings. That is why we say destiny links the unlinked, delinks the linked. This bhava chakra delinks the planets which are in one rashi to the different rashi. It may be found in the different rashi. It may come back to the same bhava. That means to say how important it is to make use of the bhava chakra. You see the astrological many writings, they forget the bhava chakra at all. They don't make use of it. Let us say one aphorism, the particular rule says, karako bhavanashaya. What it means? Karaka grahas in karakasthana will not do good. Let us say Venus is in the seventh house in the Rashi Chakra. Should we speak straight away that Shukra is a being, a karaka in the sun will destroy the seventh house? In reality, it may be either in the sixth bhava or in the eighth bhava, the karako bhavanasha will not influence. In the same way, Guru in the fifth house, Mars in the third house, Sun in the ninth house, all these are bhava karakas, and the karaka karako bhavanasha may not apply to the many people if they confuse by without making use of a bhava chakra. Bhava chakra is so important, and many, for example, any yogas. Also, we are very good in the, particularly in the Rashi Chakra, that becomes weak in the Bhava Chakra. Therefore, you have to make Bhava Chakra a most useful, efficacious chart to help you to understand the Rashi. Rashi is not complete without Bhava. Bhava is demarcated. Bhava Palas are to be read from Bhava Chakra, making use of Rashi. Because in Rashi you got exaltation, you got a Swakshetra, Uchakshetra, Mitchakshetra. All these we have to find from Rashi, not in the Bhava. Bhava is only a house. It cannot be, when a planet moves to the next Bhava, that doesn't mean it changes the Rashi. No, it remains in the same Rashi, moves to the next Bhava. This is to be properly understood. Therefore, at the outset, I have magnified the Grahasputa's influence, Bhavasputa's influence, Bhava Chakra's influence are very important. That is found in Rashi itself, and you will get so much of information next. There you can see how Bhavas are changing here. Particularly, look at the example given here. In Kanya Lagna, a man who has got Rahu in the Lagna, but actually Rahu in the Bhava Chakra, it is in the second house, second Bhava. Rahu, as you know, is a planet of mystic things. It may give aberrations, health problems, and so on. If it is in the bound, if Rahu are not to be a good lord, and thing is that his position in the Rahu gives some shadowy things, particularly on the mental plane and the physical plane, but not so in the Bhava Chakra, whereas it has shifted. Look at the Shani Chandra Yoga in the fourth house, in the Rashi Chakra, but it has already gone in the Bhava Chakra, where Moon is separated and Saturn is separated. That means to say, the yogas, what we found in the Rashi, may change, may weak that yoga. It may not work at all. Generally, Shani Chandra Yoga is the most horrible yoga. It gives mental aberrations, schizophrenia, and many times we have tested, it will come in the way of family life. Therefore, you see, simply going on the basis of the Rashi position of planet, we land in trouble. Therefore, we may have to make use of particularly the Bhava Chakra. Therefore, in the present example, you have seen how the planets are moving and things are happening. No doubt I have next. I have already interpreted how these are helpful, and we have already discussed the importance of Bhava Chakra, and without Bhava Chakra, straight away going to Rashi, sometimes we will do big mistake. As you know, is we have got many other things. Graha Sandhi, Bhava Sandhi, Nakshatra Sandhi, all these are important. The planet becomes weak in a Sandhi. See, as you know, Gandantana Nakshatra, we say, that is Revati 4, Ashwini 1, Ashlesha 4, Maka 1, Jyeshtha 4, they are Gandanta Nakshatras. Therefore, it is a Rashi Sandhi. These Sandhis are very important. Even Dasha Sandhis are also, we are saying. That is generally we in South India, and I don't know, maybe in the North also, we do Shantis. The Sandhi Kalas will do much harm. Therefore, Sandhis are very important. And Bhava Madhya, that is why even Bhava Sandhi, I have told you, it has just entered a Bhava, but it will not be giving good result because it is in the transitional position. It has not left the previous house, it cannot give the influence of the next house. That is the thing. Therefore, you have understood how Sandhi is also changing the whole pattern of the horoscope. That you have to be careful. Sometimes, if your Ayanamsha is not correct, it will show you the next nakshatra or as a previous nakshatra, then you will be in utter confusion. Therefore, all these are so important to consider. Sandhi means Dasha Sandhi, Lagna Sandhi, Bhava Sandhi, all these sandhi, nakshatra sandhis all to be understood. Now, when you interpret a Bhava, Bhava Madhya, I have told you already, Bhava Madhya, when a planet is there, that will going to be giving you good result. If it is in the beginning, it doesn't give. That I have already told you. Now, look at this position here. We are talking about the previous horoscope where the lagna was kanya lagna. Virgo lagna have to use the bhava madhya only. Wherever the midpoint falls above bhava, that rashi lord is the rashi lord becomes the bhava lord, stula lord. But sukshma lord, let us say in the first bhava, 2 degrees 53 minutes in Virgo means uttara nakshatra. That means sun becomes the second lord, first lord of the bhava. He is not only the karaka of the bhava, first bhava, and he is also the sukshma lord of the bhava. That subtlety you must understand. Generally, for every bhava you have got a karaka. Without karaka you can't interpret a bhava. And with the lord and the karaka you have to speak about the bhava. Therefore, you look at this horoscope. First bhava is ruled by sun. Second ruled by Mars. As a Libra, 2 degrees, Chitra Nakshatra. Scorpio, 3 degrees in the fag end of the Nakshatra. That is Vishakha 4. That is Guru. Third Lord is Guru, Sukshma Lord. Therefore, you see, Bhava Madhyas will give you the Nakshatras which are ruling the Sukshma controllership of the Bhava. Therefore, you have to study two things. One is Stula Lord and the Sukshma Lord. Where it brings, see how nicely it is. We have selected, no doubt, Shripati Paddhati, but practical purpose, it is good also to go for equal house division. Where it starts, where it ends, in between, where the planets are, we have to fill in. That's why Grahasputa, Bhavasputa, then only Bhavachakra. Next. Therefore, you understood the subtlety of the Bhava Chakra and other things. Now, we have been given to understand the Chandra Lagna, Surya Lagna, and Janma Lagna. What is Janma Lagna? See, in our classical text, Janma Lagna is Tanu Bhava. Lagna means Tanu. Tanu means body. Your body develops from age up to 30th year. You have got to develop yourself, your personality, your stability, your social status, all these put together, it is a Janma Lagna Bhava. When that is good, you will have good life. When the bland planets are there, the development is curtailed. When bland planets are aspecting, the Lagna suffers, the Lagna Bhava suffers. The Lagnadipati is in Dustana, there also it suffers. The Lagna is of paramount importance. To start with, life starts with the Lagna Bhava, and the Lagnadipati, Lagna Karaka are so important. Surya is Karaka for the Lagna, they say, not for Chandra Lagna. Lagna Karaka is Surya. What is Surya? Arogyam Pradadatuno Dinakaraha. Without sun's influence, your health will not be good. Therefore, his Karakatva goes to the Tanu Bhava. If Tanu Bhava has to prosper, the Lagnadipati should be good. It should not go to the Dustana. Therefore, if it goes to Dustana, because Lagna, they say, it is the receiving end of all the yogas. You may have Dharma Karma Adipati Raja Yoga. You may have Mahapurusha Yoga, Buddha Aditya Yoga. So many yogas are there. But the Lagnadipati himself is weak. What it can give you, you cannot enjoy the fruits of the yogas that has found in the Jataka when the Lagnadipati is not strong. The Lagnadipati must be very good. Therefore, your development of physics, your mind, your aspiration, your ideas, all these are bloomed or that gets settled by the 30th year. Therefore, the Surya Janma Lagna you have to see up to 30th year. Though lifelong you can see no harm, because when you talk of bhavas, first Lagna Bhava takes, the 12 bhavas start from the Lagna only. But why they have given you Chandra Lagna? Chandra Lagna is the mind, that is body. Surya is Atma, Lagnadipati is Buddha Deha, this is Manas. See, Manas Karaka Chandra. Buddhi karma anusarani. Your achievement in life is because of the mind you have. If your poor karmas are very good, your mind will be good. If not, the attitude of your mind will go in a different way. You will not love people. You find fault with others. All this negativity comes from your moon's position. Even in Nadi Shastra also, Chandra is not dubbed as a benefic. He is not a good planet. It is a cheating planet according to the Nadi. Therefore, here also, many challenges are coming in your life. Your mind should be very strong and to face the more ordeals of life. And your development, mental development takes in the Chandra Lagna period. Therefore, Chandra no doubt gives you yogas. Amala Yoga, Durdhara Yoga, Anupasanipi Yoga. All these yogas are all from Chandradhi Yoga. Just like Lagnadhi Yoga, that's why the acharyas have given you importance of Chandra. I mean, Chandra Lagna also forms yogas. Where it can go? Amala Yoga. From Lagna, Guru in 10th. Shubhagraha in 10th. From Chandra also, Shubhagraha in 10th will give you Maha Yogas like Amala Yoga. The persons will be so popular out of his country. The whole world speaks of him. Therefore, all these yogas are seen from the Lagna as well as Chandra Lagna. Their Chandra means mind. Mind has to face more ordeals. As we say, three times Sadasati comes to the Chandra Lagna. That means your mind is developed. Unless you suffer, adjust to the life of the person, you can't be happy. Therefore, it says, Saturn teaches you. In the first round, you may get married. Majority of people in our world married during Sadasati. Mostly, no doubt, in our country it is like that. Western countries are different. Ours is a karma bhumi. Therefore, according to our shastras and experience, we have found many people get married in Sadasati only. Why so? Therefore, it gives you experience of life. Unless you are responsible to your family, you have to earn your living, you have to look after your family people. All this responsibility and challenges comes after 30. Maybe some people get married before 30. After 30, you have got so much of responsibility up to 60 years. Wherein not only in the professional marriage you have to develop, you have to look after your children and get them married. Your schedule of life up to say 60 years is too much. And you have to work hard, save money, face many things, and be happy also with the family members. Therefore, much depends upon the Chandra Lagna. And of course, Surya Lagna comes into the being after 60. What is Surya? Surya tests your health. Many people get sick. Body becomes fragile, very weak. And they can't face life. And the thing is, the mind becomes dull. It cannot concentrate. More forgetfulness. Senility, we call it. Therefore, Surya Lagna comes into being. There are people who are active even after 60. Up to the end of 90 years, they will be active. Their mind will be alert. They speak and understand many things. They have got the power because the sun is so good. If sun happens to be in a good nakshatra, maybe in Pushkarna Mamsha, if the sun's position is strong in Shadbala, Surya Lagna becomes strong. Up to your activity will be there. Sun is a leader. Sun becomes active. Sun always thinks of power, position, and he can do something in life. That means Surya Lagna, even Surya Lagna period, man achieves something. Therefore, that you have to see, taking into consideration Sun as Lagna and see the position of the planet. No doubt these Chandra Lagna and Surya Lagna have given a simple chart. Look at this position. From Chandra Lagna, the 10th house is ruled by Mercury. And Mercury, though Nietzsche, aspecting his house, but he is retrograde. That means to say, this person in after Chandra Lagna, we can say he has got the 10th house more active because of his aspect. As you know, a debilitated planet, when it is retrograde, it becomes strong. Luckily, in this horoscope, Chandra Shani, though they are in one house, but Chandra, particularly in Bhav Chakra, it changes. Therefore, you have to understand there is Chandra Mangala Yoga. What we say Chandra Mangala Yoga? Chandra Yoga means immovable properties you can achieve. When there is yoga, Mangala is Bhumi Karaka. Therefore, when Mars aspects the Chandra, naturally Chandra Mangala Yoga. Chandra Yoga, Mangala Yoga gives easy property, easy money, easy things. That is what you have to understand. Therefore, you see the Guru's aspect in the fourth house, from Chandra's fourth house. That means fourth becomes very good. After 30, this man will acquire properties, and this person will have good education, further things. Therefore, taking that into Lagna and read the position of the planet, that is Chandra Lagna. And when you come to the Surya Lagna, what it says, again you have got Sun particularly in the Lagna, and in the 10th house you have got Yoga Karaka. See, you should not forget that the basic rules of astrology when you apply to the different Lagnas. For example, Sun is sitting in the Meena Lagna. For Meen Lagna, Yoga Karaka is the particularly fifth lord, and it is in the 10th house along with the Karaka. Therefore, the professionally activity is there, and of course, he is aspecting particularly Buddha. Who is Buddha? The lord of the fourth and the seventh. Therefore, he is destined to have good life even after 30, because the Chandra Lagna has become good with many yogas. Therefore, like this, you have to read. In the same way, you see Sun is with Rahu, is with Ketu. And of course, look at this position. Saturn aspects the Kanya, Mars aspects the Kanya. What it means? Whenever two powerful malefics are aspecting a particular house, that house will have problems. Look at this Lagna. It is from Surya Lagna, it is the seventh house. There is problem connected with the partner, maybe health, life, danger, all these things are put together when you read the Surya Lagna. Therefore, this gives you hint from the Rashi only. All this, what I am doing is from Rashi Chakra only I am doing. I am not referring to any divisional chart or anything, even an Ashtavarga. When you take up Ashtavarga, there is another problem. See, we have got equal house division and unequal house, and we erect the Bhava Chakra and so on. Whether we have to put Ashtakarga for the Bhava chart or to the Rashi chart, when you take Ashtakarga for the Bhava chart, the duration of the house will change, because each Kaksha has got 3 degrees 45 minutes, whereas when you have got a difference of 28 degrees or 32, you have to divide 8 Kakshas according to the Lagna Pramana. Then confusion comes. Therefore, these are all the subtle difficulties, no doubt. People like C.S. Patel have done lot of work in Ashtakvarga. And for practical purpose, one can no doubt follow this particularly Rashi. But when you go to particularly for unequal division, and if you want to erect Ashtakvarga on the basis of Bhav Chakra, it may not give you easy walk through, but it will have to face ordeal. Therefore, such subtle difficulties are available when you go to the minor charts. Then next. Now becomes a very big thing for astrologers. Kendra Adipatya Dosha. What is Kendra Adipatya Dosha? If benefics are controlling the Kendras, they have Kendra Adipatya Dosha. But Parivinipation, the slokas have not been properly read. The Sloka says, the Guru has got so much of Dosha. Next to him is Shukra. And the least planet is Buddha. And this Kendra Adipatya Dosha will affect if it is having a Markasthana. And Maraka qualities you must have. And if it is occupying a Maraka sthana, then only this Kendra Adipati Dosha. You can't dub a planet, a benefic planet, owning Kendra or Trikona as a papi. How do you use the papi word for Guru, for Kanya Lagna people? Guru is the Lord of the fourth and seventh, who becomes a papi account to Kendradhipatya Dosha. Therefore, Acharyas have given some more rules to cancellation of this Kendradhipatya Dosha. What are these dosha parihara? When malefics of the horoscope aspect this Kendradhipatya Dosha Graha, the Kendradhipatya Dosha will go. The next thing is, if Kendradhipatya Dosha Grahas are found in Dustanas, there also particularly the Kendradhipatya Dosha will go. And another school of thought is that malefic and benefics of a horoscope should be decided on Moola Trikona. Every planet has got two houses, for your information. Guru, especially for Kanya Lagna people, fourth and the seventh house. Fourth is Moola Trikona house. Among the two houses, if he has got one Moola Trikona, that having a good jurisdiction, Shubhasthana, he becomes a very good lord. Therefore, we can't attribute more Kendradhipatya Dosha to a guru. And majority, I practically studied many horoscopes. Unless they are in a Markasthana, this Kendradhipatya Dosha won't work. No doubt for Kanya Lagna is a Badaka, is the seventh house. For Dishobha Lagna, Sar Rashi, seventh house is Badakasthana. For Char Rashi, the 11th house is Badakasthana. For Stira Lagna, the ninth lord becomes the Badaka Adipati. Therefore, in this horoscope, Kanya Lagna people, seventh not only becomes Kendradhipatya Dosha Graha, but also a Badaka. Simply word Badaka means, don't think it will do Badaka always. Badaka Grahas in Badaka Sthana, and Badaka period has to come. And not only Badaka, planets in the Badaka Sthana also afflict the position of in a particular period. Therefore, another redeeming fact, particularly for Kendradhipatya Dosha, if it is in a Uchastana in Namamsa, there also, these are not found in general books. There are scholars who have done good lot of research. The old people, they have got secrets. And this on the basis of the chart, Navamsha and Moola Trikona, they are going to be, because the Moola Trikona, we are not making use at all. Simply say, Swakshetra, Moola Trikona. You see horoscopes having Meena Lagna people. Shukra is Uccha there. But you should know that he is the Lord of the Eighth and Moola Trikona Lord. Moola Trikona Lord exalted in the Lagna. Being a malefic, he is the eighth lord. Whenever a Moola Trikona lord gets a Dustanadipatya sitting in a particular house, that house will have problem. I've seen many horoscopes, young children, girls, having Shukra exalted in the Lagna. They deserted the house, left the parents in love affairs and suffered in life. In the same way, particularly Shani in the Lagna, being the lord of the 12th, who is Moola Trikona Lord, sitting in the Lagna of Meena, has also created problem. Therefore, like this, the malefics and benefics of the horoscope should be based on Moola Trikona. That is the reason why Moola Trikona has been in Swakshetra. What is the difference between Moola Trikona and Swakshetra? There must be something important. Do you mean to say both are powerful? Let us say, for example, see, Mesha Lagna people, eighth lord is Mars. But you should know that Mesha is Moola Trikona for Mars. He becomes very strong. Like that, we have to understand very important things. For example, where Mesha Lagna Buddha becomes the most horribly exalted is. I have seen horoscopes where Moola Trikona lords, having Dustana Adipatya, sitting in particularly Dustana or seventh house. I have seen horoscope having Mesha Lagna Buddha in the seventh house, three times married. You understand? Therefore, this Moola Trikona will create much difficulty when they occupy important house. Next.
Sir, Vasan sir,
Yeah.
very difficult for me to say, but we are coming close to the time. So
Boys, I will very closely see.
Okay, fine sir, fine.
These
sir,
are
fine,
very sir. Quickly, I'll tell you. I took a
okay,
lot of
fine.
time in explaining.
I know, no, sir, I know it's a very interesting, sir. That's why I could not say anything to you, sir. But
see, I told you already, Karakas Bhava.
Karaka,
Paladipika, you got Karakat Bhavam, Bhavat Bhavam, Lagnat Bhavam. Therefore, in the Rashi Chakra, you have got to study all these things. See, not only Shukra is the Karaka for the seventh house, from Shukra, seventh house. And for Bhava, seventh house is Saptama Bhava, Bhavat Bhavam, it is. And another very important thing is, you do not check Aroha and Arohan planet proposition. Some planets are in Aroha, some planets in Avaroha. You know Avaroha and Avaroha, when they are going towards exaltation is Aroha, when they are going towards, I give you one example. Indira Gandhi was running Saturn Dasha when she, at the end of life. See, when Saturn Dasha was running, Saturn was in Aroha during the Dasha. And the moment Saturn went to Vrishika, she did not leave. Therefore, so much is there in the Rashi Chakra itself to assess. And I have to say Pushkar Namamsha, Pushkar Bhaga, all the Astangata Dosha, Nichatva, Kartari Yoga, Shubhakartari, so much is there in the Rashi. Therefore, what is my interest in presenting this paper is, you have got so much is in the Rashi Chakra itself, and you can understand many things. Don't neglect the Rashi and straight away go to division chart or any Sukshma understanding. With this, I am very happy to give my presentation at a time when our old friend Kedarji's memorial lecture is being arranged. I am indeed very happy. I thank everyone to have heard my talk and the organizers who have given me a chance to express what I felt about this science. Thank you very much.
Dr. Vasan,
yes.
It's always a pleasure and privilege both to hear you.
Yeah.
And I'm more than sure the youngsters, they shall not only benefit it, they shall learn the technique which that they can use later on. Your idea behind this series, whether Dr. Raman series or Kedarji Memorial, is that the youngsters, they should know what my stalwarts have been doing so far, what are their techniques, and more than that, the experience which they have gathered so far. Most important part is that experience.
Experience is important.
Yes. So we want that they must learn from this experience. This is not going to get them from any book. This can come only from experience and only by listening to our stalwarts. So, in fact, if I want to say something about you, I would provide a first lecture for me, just to talk about Dr. Vasan. And Pradeep is saying time is short. So I will not say more, but only thing is that certain techniques of Dr. Vasan, they are priceless. And I share request Pradeep and Namnit both, they must organize 3-4 lectures from you, wherein the different techniques, they can be told in at length. Anyway, Dr. Vasan, thank you very much. I really enjoyed the whole lecture.
Thank you very much, sir.
Okay.
Thank you.